It was a day I'll never forget, a day that will live in my memory till I breathe my last breath. Our local newspaper announced that an exhibit was coming to town for a 3-day engagement. A strange and chilling exhibition, displaying weapons and instruments used by the criminally insane to torture, maim, and murder their victims. I may never know why, but an overwhelming curiosity consumed me as I read the paper's announcement, and I planned my attendance for the first day of this macabre event. Glass cases housed the wide variety of weapons. Most were familiar, the guns, the knives, each with its own gruesome tale. But there were other things. Instruments of death crudely fashioned from the minds of maniacs. One such item caught my attention, a cord no longer than 2 feet in length with a metal washer knotted at each end. A simple device, yet responsible for the decapitation of 17 unfortunate victims, so the card read. It was simply called the garrote. I stood and stared intently at this dreadful object, this garrote. To this day, I do not know what possessed me to do what I did next. But in that moment, an unforeseen force compelled me to reach into the unlocked case, remove this tool of death, and hold each end in my hands. I pulled the ends, and the cord tightened. I tried to imagine the madman's mind as he commenced his evil deed. That's when it happened. Suddenly, and without warning, a strange sensation engulfed each of my hands. It was as though I no longer had control. Try as I may, I could not loosen my grip on the hideous contraption. Instead, my hands gripped the garrote even tighter. Then the unspeakable occurred. My hands, now under the control of unexplainable forces, began to slowly move towards my own throat. Mustering every ounce of strength within me, I could still not stop what was happening as the cord made contact with my flesh. Back and forth, my hands moved as though they were sawing through timber. I screamed, but no sound came from my mouth as the cord penetrated deeper and deeper into the flesh, blood, and bone of my body. Somehow, I had awakened the tormented soul of the madman, and he was now in control. The cord was now halfway through my neck. I accepted my fate. Then, as suddenly as this nightmare began, it ended. In that moment, control of my hands returned to me. I had to rid my body of this ghastly apparatus. Again, my hands moved from side to side, but this time to free the cord from the flesh that enclosed it. Slowly, I forced it forward until at last, it broke free. I clutched my throat, only to find no injury, no scar, no evidence at all that a horrendous event had just taken place. But the memory of the garrote lives on.